Now to your headlines. The owner of a local vape lounge wants to warn marijuana dispensary owners about a scam involving a bogus utility company that he was targeted for. News 5's Jessica Barreto explains how they were trying to scam him out of hundreds. Jessica?
Well, Damon Johnson says the person on the phone threatened to shut off power unless he paid for his utility meter. The first time they tried to scam him out of $300, asking him to send a MoneyGram through a pharmacy or gas station. He didn't fall for it either time, but this time around he learned even more about the scammer's tactics.
Jamin Johnson has owned Speakeasy Vape Lounge for 6 years. A year ago, he got a scam call from a bogus utility company asking him to send money for a meter cannabis dispensaries use. 2 days ago, he got another one around 4 o'clock in the evening.
Telling me that they had installed it but had never received payment for it. And so they were sending a technician out to remove my meter, which would effectively disconnect my utilities. At that moment, I laughed and I said, hey, just so you know, I know what you guys are doing. I know this is a scam. And to my surprise, the gentleman got very cordial with me and laughed back and said, oh, so you know about this one, huh?
The scammer even bluntly admitting his intentions.
We know you guys are high. We call you and we hit you over the head.
They call you at the end of the day. They choose a time that they believe that you're going to be distracted or inebriated.
Johnson says they're well versed in regulations and use that knowledge to take advantage.
I was impressed. You know, it showed insight. It showed reasoning and thinking.
But he wants dispensary owners to stay one step ahead and not fall victim.
They're aware that for a lot of us, that's a make or break situation, that we're one bad business day away from losing all we have. And so they're capitalizing on our fear.
Johnson says he suspects the scammers are also gathering intel from people in the industry who scope out the different businesses, and he hopes this serves as a warning for dispensary owners to stay alert. Always watching out for you, Colorado Springs, Jessica Barreto, News 5.
Well, thank you, Jessica.